What's going on? This is Crazy Russian 86 here, and I'm about to leave the place where I stay with my girlfriend, go to work, unfortunately. You all know this integer, I want to say Happy New Year to you too, and you know, you among other people like you, David Duke, and other people open my eyes to the diversity and how detrimental is it to the human psyche. You know, today I just blew up at one of my former friends because he owes me money. I cast him out on the voicemail. And I told him if I'm not gonna get the money, I'm not going to a goodbye party which he invited me to. Because he keeps saying he's gonna give me money back and he's been bullshitting and blowing me off and he has money. But I understand that that's just genetic thing, you know. But still. You know, I'm dating black woman, but like I said, sometimes I feel like, you know, there's a reason for everything, 'cause my Jewish parents are not particularly for it, but I'm not gonna listen to them because, you know, it sucks being a Jew anyway, because the Jewish people, they ruined the world, they killed the Lord Jesus Christ, they brought Adolf Hitler on themselves because they destroyed Germany and they destroyed Russia and, you know. They made revolutions and stuff, so. And I'm gonna put the link here in description about Jewish rabbi who speaks in Hebrew and he was reading Mein Kampf. So. And he was explaining why Jewish people fucked up so badly, so. For all the Jews out there watching my video, you have to watch that video as well. It's in Hebrew, but it's with English subtitles. It's a great video. You know. And you, Cynthia, Jew, should watch that too. I know you don't care about it because you're all about black people, which is understandable. Because you're black, well. I'm not sure you're purely black, you probably have some Jewish in you too. Because A, you're light skinned, and B, you're smarter than most blacks. So, I don't think you have a typical black IQ, so. And also, watching your videos helped me to understand how fucked up the society is where you're living at. Like, it's really so fucked up. And people are gonna dig dirt on you, lie on you, do all this bullshit. Just to demote you if they don't like you. And she pointed out a lot of truth about the employment law in America. And I have nothing to say but actually agree with her. Cynthia G, you're the very smart woman, like I have a lot of respect for you. And I'm gonna keep watching your great videos every day. Just keep making them every day. I hope that one day you're gonna notice me and we're gonna actually do Google Hangout or something, because I would like to have a discussion, because like I said, dear Cynthia G, I think that you're generalizing people too much and you don't see the world in complete way, you know. Even though I agree with the main idea that, you know, you should be separatist and, you know, you say that black people shouldn't contribute money to white businesses. And I feel the same way. I shouldn't be giving money to my half-bred friends, you know, because the guy who basically screwed me for money, it's not a lot, but still. He's like half bred, he's like half white, half black, but he looks black. And another guy who fucked me for money a little bit, and also he started giving back to me, whom I punched in the face, Dave. He's completely mixed up because he has Asian, German, French, and Scottish in him or something like that. So it's like, he's like completely, you know, genetically damaged. So, and that explains a lot, you know, like now when I'm getting older and wiser and I'm realizing, like, I see in people how they are and I see the world, I'm like, damn. Maybe there is a correlation between your genetic type and your mindset and things like that. And a lot of times people don't like diversity. And also, dear CNTG, there's another video I'm gonna put here. There is a white man talking about things. And I'm gonna send this video to you. So hopefully you're gonna talk about it, because I found it pretty interesting. And you probably agree with that white guy too. He's also against diversity too, cause like, he even said that diversity causes the hostile work environment. And I went through it, I have nothing to say but to agree with it, you know. Cause I work with mostly black people, but then we have a couple other foreigners, and every time if something goes wrong with black, white, black, African-American people, they always blame foreigners. They always blame me. They've been talking shit a little bit about Indian guy, but not as much anymore, I didn't hear it. They've been talking shit about Africans. So, like, I notice all of this thing, whereas foreigners are always at fault. They're always the bad guys, no matter what. There is always a person who is genetically different from you and who have different mentality from you. That person always is a bad guy. You black woman in white corporation, you're gonna be bad. You Jew in a black-owned corporation, you're gonna be always the bad guy. Shit. I have a friend who is like white guy and he was in an Indian-owned corporation. And he got fired because he was the only white guy and he got discriminated against. So see, it's important to be among people who are like you. Otherwise, you're always gonna experience problems, discrimination, and you're always gonna be a bad guy. On this note, let me just take the dog for the final walk and go back to work. Work with these people. Hopefully it's gonna be a good day. Hopefully nobody's gonna give me no bullshit today like they didn't yesterday. Hopefully I'm just gonna go to work, clock in, do my job and clock out. Peace. And this is my last video in my nice girlfriend's apartment. Look at this fucking beautiful place. It's so beautiful. My girlfriend, she has a good taste, and she told me too that, you know, if you wanna live decent life, you cannot be cheap. Which I agree with her. But I also told her, you know what? If you live in an oppressive society where the system is against you, that hinders your opportunity to make good money, that hinders your opportunity to go for growth, and that puts you in a situation where your best bet is to be cheap and to live cheap, you know? Because if you want to spend good money, you have to make good money. And if you're poor and at disadvantage, it's not smart for you to spend everything you have to look decent, to look nice. Because if you have no money, you always be fucked. You know, that's how it is. Money is something which can help you from being fucked in the ass in this fucked up society. And this is something which can help you sustain and live and survive. And being different hinders your ability to make a decent money. That's just how it is. And being different puts you in a situation where you have to use the law for your advantage and where you have to go through all kinds of nerve-wracking experiences and you have to deal with people who, like UGTNTG said, your spiritual enemies. This is just how it is. That's why, you know, you have to just live, not to live above your means, you know. So, this dog is lying on my lap again, just like, the dog is so happy to lie on my lap, she can lie there like for the rest of the day, but I need to go though. So, this is gonna end this beautiful video for Cynthia G. So, let me see something, what's going on in here. Yeah, it goes to down to Cynthia G and I'm out. All the best to you guys, peace out, later.